2018 was a year which was very eventful for me. It was full of lessons and learnings, and I learned a lot of things about myself, about people. And 2018 is something that I would really cherish throughout my life because I learned a lot of things in 2018.
And
And
it was deep.
I'm going to show you guys what all things happened over the 12 months of 2018, starting from January. So in January, I was actually in India for 15 days. I came back on 14th of January to US. So I was visiting my family and I did get my eyes operated. I did a smile LASIK surgery for my eyes and it was amazing. I had so much good food and I came back with a very positive mindset, I want to say. I visited Golden Temple before coming and that's the place that really gives me so much of positivity. So when I came back from India to US, I was really happy and a little bit sad, but mostly I was happy to start my journey here, like literally, started. And I went through a quick reset routine for a week where I was, resetting all of my room, my vibe, and I just wanted to be happy and be around people who are full of positivity. And in February, I actually got my new laptop. So I finally managed to save up money to buy a new MacBook Pro, and it was like, oh my God, I was so excited when my laptop came and I didn't open it for like 2 weeks because I didn't have all the protective gadgets around it, and it was so amazing. I wanted a new laptop for such a long time only because my other laptop was really bad. And then in March, my room was finally ready. I just breezed through the spring semester. I was just working most of the time, and then also I finally did my room and I uploaded my room tour, which was very well received. So thank you so much for loving my room tour. So yeah, my room finally came, and I'm kind of a person who believes that your surroundings reflect you. So I wanted my room to be very chill, very chic, and very nice, and it was something that should reflect my personality. So yeah, I'm someone who relates to environments and your surroundings a lot. And
And
then in
then
April it was my birthday, so I packed up my bag and me and my best friend went for a trip to Miami. And I am a water baby. I love beaches. I love water. And it was like the perfect birthday trip that I could have imagined. Although it was just for 3 4 days, but it was so amazing. We had so much fun at the beach and we were just exploring. And I met her after like
but
6 months. And the highlight of my birthday, or the highlight of my year, was I went for underwater diving and I actually hugged a shark. Yes, you heard it
hugged
right.
a
I
shark.
hugged and it was so good. Oh my God, it's still like fresh in my mind and I loved
See,
it. And then May was full of, self-care. I was focused all on myself. I went out for coffee with myself and I was just evolving as a person. So I tried to imbibe a lot of new things. I made plans for myself and it was all about me in May and it felt so good. Like I realized how much energy and time we spent on others instead of spending it on ourselves.
so
And
yeah.
then in June I actually started to work out. I did yoga and I did Pilates and everything for 2 months. It was an amazing time for me. I am so regretting that I stopped doing it after the summer because I should have continued. And then I went for a detox. It was a 1 month of detox from June 6th to July 6th. I did not have any coffee or anything caffeine, no outside food, nothing. I was all focused about, cleansing my body and my surroundings. So it was an amazing time for me. I did a video on it as well. And then I also created a vision board. So the summer was all about, recreating myself and having a vision for myself. So in June, I made my vision board, which was, I think, a very good step for me. And I'm still sticking onto the vision board that I made. I just keep changing it up, but it's still a very, very integral part. And then in July, I worked on a couple of routines. I wanted to wake up early, so I started waking up super early in July. And then I made up like a study routine and also my evening routine and morning routine. So because my life was so clustered around different things, I really wanted to get my life back together. So July was all about, working out on different routines, trying out different things for myself. And in August, I went on another girls' trip, which was an amazing road trip to Arizona. So we went to the Grand Canyon and we had an amazing road trip time. I uploaded the vlog very recently. If you guys have not checked it out, it was my best friend's birthday and and we had so much fun. It was like four sisters chilling, and we went for these amazing dinners, and we had like, it was amazing, and like it was very good, and it's something that everyone should experience in their life. A girl's road trip is all you need to let yourself go and really, you know, be at it. And then in September, I was mostly studying and preparing for my literature seminar, which was in October. So September was all about studying, and I did my bullet journal for the first time in September, which really got me into bullet journaling. And in October, so on 12th of October, I had my literature seminar, which you guys saw the clips, and I studied my ass off for this exam, and I passed it, and I was so happy and ecstatic that I was finally able to clear the exam. And then in the end of October, I went for a trip to Edinburgh in Texas. It was like a very small work trip, but it turned out to be really good for me because I had like the conferences in the daytime, and in the evening I was exploring a lot of things on my own, and then my flight got delayed by 8 hours. So I had more time to explore the city and a very different part of South Texas. It was very different from where I live in, and it was so much more southern, and it was so much more fun and everything. And I visited a dog cafe. I was there for like 3 hours. I worked on a couple of things. I met new dogs. I read Harry Potter first chapter, which is yay. So yeah, it was like very fun for me. And then in November, again, I went for a road trip in Texas. So yeah, I went there with my friends. So we went to Houston, we went to Austin. I had a really, really nice time there, and we ate like crazy people. We had so much of Indian thalis and Indian food, and it was like super yummy. And in the end of November, I started the 30 days of video series where I was uploading every single day of the month, starting from 25th of November till 25th of December. And it was so good, you guys. A lot of you loved it. It was definitely a very hard time for me because I was like getting up at 4 o'clock in the morning to edit and upload so that it goes live in India's evening time. And it was definitely a challenge for me because during that time, I also had a lot of work pressure for my research. But I am so proud of myself for, you know, getting through it. And I am so, so happy and grateful for you guys who showed so much love to me. Like, you were so understanding. And I think I met some amazing subscribers. We're like friends now. And then in December, it was pretty much the same. I had a couple of exams that I was preparing for. And then I was working on my videos nonstop. And then in the end of December, I went for a Europe trip to with my sister. So she lives in Germany. I visited her, and so I visited Amsterdam. I was in Germany for some time. I was in Amsterdam. I visited Belgium, Brussels, and I also visited Lake Como in Italy and Milan. And you know, it was so good. It was so amazing. It was like a very much needed a break. And since this 2018 has been a year of travel for me, my year started with travel, and there was a lot of travel in between, and then it ended on an epic Europe trip, which was like, still I'm still not ready to absorb that I was there. So yeah, this year has been full of ups and downs, and most of the times I wanted to share my ups with you guys. I didn't wanted to share my lows because I'm not that kind of a person. And I am so happy that it is over. It was full of learnings, and 2018 would always be very, very close to my heart. And I'm so looking forward to 2019. This was my 2018 in a review. Thank you so much. And I'll see you guys in my next video really soon. Bye.